It's time for The Mix at 6. Counting down the top hip-hop and R&B songs in the country. The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's number one station for hip-hop and R&B. Soul and reggae.
Shock the system.
Vibe Club.
Vibe Club.
For life. It's Monday. It's 6 o'clock, which don't only mean one thing. It means that you are here with me. And who is me, you might be asking? I am Khalil Creed, your esteemed and humble host and presenter of this place that we have all cultivated together, the Palace of Positivity that encompasses what Vibe Club is all about, which means you're here for The Mix at 6. It means that we're here at The Mix 88.9. It means that we're here for another week of glorious, glorious positivity and idea sharing and music and entertainment and all of that that I provide or try to provide to you on a daily basis, Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern, because the Eastern is important because of the time zone difference. I keep explaining that, but people still ask me why I say Eastern. That's why I say Eastern. I say Eastern because I am on the East Coast. And if you're listening to me on the West Coast and you tune in at 6 p.m., you're going to miss me. You're going to miss me because it's going to be 9 o'clock here. But that's okay, because we'll still have something on for you. We'll have some quality content on the app for you. But it just won't be me. It just won't be me personally. So if you want to listen to this voice, this one right here, that's coming through the airwaves right now, that you love so much, I have to say Eastern. I have to let you know the time zone. Because we are everywhere. We're not just here. We're in the interwebs. We're in the cyberspace. We're everywhere. We can be heard in all places. That's the flexibility of this app and of this stream and of being on the internet. You can be everywhere. I can be everywhere. And I am everywhere. But I hope you had a great weekend. I hope that you had a great first day back at work. I hope that you went to work today with no charges, no court appearances, no court fines, no arrests on your record, no none of that. I hope you went out and had a very productive weekend. I hope you went out and had a good time. And even if you just stayed home, I hope you had a good time staying home. I hope that you read a good book, which, by the way, speaking of books, I'm still waiting on my Will book to get here. It was supposed to have been here yesterday. That's what Amazon told me. That it will be here yesterday, and it was not here yesterday. And I checked it, and it says contact the USPS, United States Postal Service, and ask them where it's at. That ain't what I pay you for, Amazon. These Amazon Prime deliveries haven't been very prime lately. I can't take credit for that. I heard that. I read that on Facebook. Somebody said that these Amazon Prime deliveries haven't been prime lately, and I thought it was funny. But I'll never take credit for something that's not mine. I'll never say a joke or something funny that I think is funny and not give credit to the person who said it. I forgot who said it, though, but it wasn't me. I didn't make it up. But it is true. It does hold true. They have not been very prime, and I hope it comes here today before I leave to, because my oldest daughter has cheerleading practice today, so I'm hoping that it's here before then, so I'll have something to do since they closed the practice. They won't let parents into practice anymore, because cheer parents are crazy. Cheer parents don't know how to act. Not all of them. I'm not saying all y'all crazy. All of them. I say y'all like I'm not one of them. But all y'all ain't crazy, but some cheer parents are crazy. Like, you know what you see on, like, the reality shows where the kids be cheerleading and the moms be going crazy and yelling and all that? That stuff's real. They really be doing that. They really be doing that. And so they closed the practice. They won't let us in no more. So I got to find something to do for an hour and a half instead of driving back across town, because I'm not going to do that. So I'm hoping my book comes today so I have something to do, because I'm really looking forward to reading it. I've been hearing nothing but good things, and I want to experience too. But other than my book not coming, I really don't have any complaints about the weekend. I had a pretty good weekend. I had a chill Friday, did some security work on Saturday, and watched some football on Sunday.
How about them Cowboys? Yeah!
TJ, you are correct. TJ, of course, is Texas Jimmy. That is my esteemed co-host. You don't hear him very often. You only hear him like once a week. After my Dallas Cowboys come back from a win, when we have a good weekend, when we have a firm, strong victory, you hear from TJ, Texas Jimmy. Texas Jimmy is correct. How about them Cowboys? We whooped the Falcons. And I don't want to hear nothing. I don't want to hear nothing about how good the Falcons were. The Falcons were 4-4. The Falcons had won 3 of their last 4 games. The Falcons beat a very formidable Saints team who had beat the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, who are the defending Super Bowl champions. I do not want to hear it. I am riding high. We got our tails kicked last week, and we came out swinging, and we didn't stop swinging for 4 quarters, and we won the game 43-3. Last week I came out here, I was humbled. I was quiet. I was subdued because we were pulled down from my high top. We were pulled down from the high peak. We were pulled down from our mountain. We were pulled down from the momentum that we had. But not anymore. Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Me. Us. You got to hear this for the next week. This is what you tuned in for. This is what you asked for. This is what you're going to get. How about them Cowboys? Feels so good. Feels so good. Last week was rough. After a loss and being sick, last week was a rough week. It was a rough week. But don't worry, because your boy is back. Don't even worry about it. People can't stand us Cowboy fans because, and I'll admit it, we are the worst when we win. And a lot of us are horrible when we lose. When we lose, we get quiet. When we stop talking, not me. I talk regardless. If I'm here for it when I'm talking, when we lose, I'm still here for it because I can take it just like I can give it. But here's my question, and I never understood this. People always say, we can't stand y'all because y'all always say this is y'all year, or y'all team is the best, or y'all America's team. First off, we didn't name ourselves America's team. The media named us America's team. We didn't say it. They said it, and we earned it. So, we are America's team. 2, what are we supposed to do? What are we supposed to do? Are we supposed to say, oh no, our team gonna suck this year. We ain't gonna do nothing. No! You're supposed to support your team. You're supposed to think that your team is the best at all times, at all phases of... Now, I'm realistic. If I don't see that we have the talent, I will say, it's iffy. I don't know. We'll see. But when I feel it like I do this year, it's nothing you can say to me. You can't stop me. You can't stop me. So I'm supposed to support my team. And I hear from everybody. I hear from all kind of fans. I hear from Uncle Chucky with them sorry Saints he like. I hear from Jack Woodson with them sorry Raiders that he like. And I needed his team yesterday. I needed them to shut down Patrick Mahomes because of them, I lost my fantasy football league. I'm still mad about that. So that's why I'm mad at the Raiders today. So, Jack, that's your team. So y'all need to figure that out. I thought y'all was gonna do something. Had me already. I was winning all the way up to the fourth quarter, and then y'all let Patrick Mahomes go off like that, and then I lost fantasy football. I was winning and everything. I was feeling good going into that game last night. I was feeling good. We had just won at 1 o'clock. I watched. Before I forget, I watched The Harder They Fall this weekend. Man, if y'all ain't seen The Harder They Fall on Netflix about the Rufus Buck gang and the Nat Love gang, the Black Western that's on Netflix, man, y'all better take 2 hours out of y'all time and sit down. And I say 2 hours and you hear 2 hours and you're like, 2 hours, I'm telling you. Once you start watching it, you gonna watch it all the way through. I watched it twice on Saturday. I sat down, I started it on Friday night, and I shouldn't have done that because I was too tired and I fell asleep. So I started it over Saturday, and I watched the whole thing on Saturday, and I watched it again later that day. That movie is good. The movie is good, and then the soundtrack is good. Yo, I'm telling y'all, if y'all haven't seen The Harder They Fall yet, I'm not going to tell y'all nothing that happened in it. I'm not going to spoil it at all because it's that good of a movie. If y'all ain't seen that, y'all missing out. You have got to go watch The Harder They Fall on Netflix. But back to what I was saying, going back to these football fans that get on my nerves, the Eagles fans, I hate them with every fiber of my being. I hate them with every fiber of my soul. I cannot stand these Eagles fans. They have nothing to be happy about. Okay, they are 4 games behind us in the NFC East, and everybody is telling me, well, the NFC East sucks. We're holding up our end. We're doing our part. We are 7-2. Okay? We are 7-2. These other teams, the Eagles, the Giants, the Washington football team, they not holding up their end. If they were worth something, we would be a formidable division. That's not my fault. All we can do is play our games and do what we do, and that's what we've been doing. But I can't stand these Eagles fans. They get on my nerves. They ain't got nothing to say until after their game is over. Until after their game is over, if they win. If they win. Now, I know a couple. There's a couple who do talk like I talk, and I respect them. Those I got, it's maybe a handful of them. I can count them on one hand. But the rest of you Eagle fans get on my nerves. Y'all get on my nerves. I hate y'all. Because y'all don't talk to after y'all win, and y'all won't shut up, and all y'all do is watch us. Y'all do is watch us Cowboys and see if we win or lose. If we win and y'all lose, I don't hear from y'all. It's radio silence. I don't hear nothing from y'all. But let y'all win a little Peasley game and we happen to lose. Oh, y'all won't shut up now. Y'all watch us more than y'all watch everybody else. And I'm going to say it here and I'm going to leave it here. The reason y'all hate us is because y'all ain't us. That's what I'm going to say. The reason y'all hate us Cowboys is because y'all ain't us. And any team that got jealousy towards, any fan base that got jealousy towards us, it's because your team ain't our team. That's not my fault. You made bad decisions. It's not my fault you picked a bad team. It's not my fault. You watch us, whether you hate us or you love us, you watch. You watch it to see if we lose, and you watch if you love us to see if we win. Either way, you gonna watch us. Take that. Take that. Y'all got me hyped this Monday. I'm supposed to be a good day. I got my blood pressure up. You got me up here yelling on the people's airwaves, talking about y'all sorry fans. Now, I will say, in the past I've had problems with the Washington football team fans and the Giants fans. They don't bother me. They really don't, because they don't talk. Well, the Giants fans really don't talk. I know a bunch of Giants fans, but they don't talk. The Washington football team fans would be talking if they were winning, but they know their position. And they're playing their position, and I respect that. I can respect that. They know where they're at, and they know what they are, and they're being that. And that's cool. I have no problem with that. But them Eagle fans, we already beat y'all once this year, and I can't wait to play y'all again, to sweep y'all again this year. Sweep y'all again for the second time this year. I'm hyped for it. I'm hyped now. I'm so ready for football. But I tell you one thing. If we mess around and don't make it to the Super Bowl this year, oh, y'all going to have a sad host on y'all hands. Oh, y'all going to have a sad host. Y'all going to have a sad show on y'all hands. I'm telling y'all now, 6 or 7 going to be the depression hour. 6 or 7, we're going to change it from the mix at 6 to the depression at 6. To the sad host at 6. Oh, it's going to be doom and gloom. Oh, from 6 to 7. Oh, it's going to be a bad week. It's going to be a bad week. But we ain't got to worry about that right now. We got to worry about what we at right now. Right now, we're in a good place. Right now, we're here for the Mix at 6. Right now, you're here for the top 6 hits in the nation. So let's go ahead and get into those. Here is number 6. Here is Chris Brown and Young Thug featuring Future, Lil Durk, and Mulatto. Go Crazy Remix here on the Mix at 6 on the Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip-hop countdown. Yo. Number 6.
Crazy, he put me in that Corvette, that why the hate me. Yeah, they a pin, cause we grown. Turn a one night stand to a happy home. On God.
Trip to your crib in the middle of the night. I know that you miss me, cause I put it down right damn, babe. I can put you on a flight. You know that a like me can change your life, oh babe.
They think you're shy, but you're a freak. That's why I spoil you. I could've hit it for the free. Christian Dior, you. I'm sweeping you out for your feet in a spaceship. I come through, go swimming in the middle of the night. We trending worldwide, cause baby, we're a vibe. Had a with a Muslim and a Christian. I swapped out religions. Felt like Jesus Christ when I did it. Have you ever went skinny dipping on a flight? PJ came with a bag full of ice. Oh, babe, I could change every life. Solitaire is whiter than rice, going crazy.
I could've whispered to this on this remix. She just came out of twat, I can see it. Like the pussy, the enemy every time, gotta kill it. Trying to live against life in the mirror.
Break it back, Kelly got you flyed in a kite. Rich, she made a virgin twice. Don't block none of these goofies, just curb these guys. Reminisce about what you had when you see what I got. You're amazing when calm down to showing you mine. You my favorite girl, and y'all wanna know why. I done changed wardrobes, I done changed your style. I'ma change your life, don't tell me it's about cloud.
Trip to your crib in the middle of the night. I know that you miss me, cause I put it down right down, babe. I can put you on a flight. You know that a like me can change your life, oh babe. Everything you do is amazing. Ain't nobody got to go crazy. I got what you need. Everybody think you shy, but I know you.
And you're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 6 song, Chris Brown and Young Thug, featuring Future, Lil Durk, and Mulatto, the Go Crazy remix. And moving right along into our number 5 song, here is Silk Sonic, Leave the Door Open.
Give me the hip hop countdown. Yo!
Number 5.
You're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number 5 song, Silk Sonic, Leave the Door Open. Earlier this morning, DaBaby and his, well, not his girlfriend, his baby's mother, I guess, Danny Lea, got into an argument, and he actually started to live stream on Instagram Live. You can see him recording her as they're arguing while she's sitting on the bed, and here is the audio.
Hey, there I go. Damn. Do my thing. You.
It's cuckoo for Cocoa Puff.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah, you want to record me talking about, shut the
up. I got to record you for my safety.
Yeah, go ahead. This the first thing.
You ain't finna burn. Now I'll get your phone.
Baby, the first time.
Yeah, that's what it is.
Like this.
Nah. Go with your move, yeah, crazy whatever. Girl.
He did end up calling the police on her to have her removed from the house. And I have audio of when the police arrived also.
Look at this. He wants me to get out of his house. Go ahead.
Okay, let's just
go ahead, baby. Tell him. Ma'am. Tell him. Where's he at? Yeah, whatever. He want to call cops on me for whatever the reason. Whatever. Stupid. My 3-month-old baby. Yeah, whatever. Hey, yeah, whatever.
You want to just tell me your side of what's
going on? No, I don't need to tell you nothing.
Well, I'd like to know.
Nah, you good. You can talk to him because he want to call you guys. Go ahead. Go ahead. Nah, go ahead. Ain't nobody need to talk to nothing. Go ahead.
Now, both of them have since released statements, very lengthy statements, about what happened and what was going on. And from what I'm gathering, it's pretty much he wanted her to leave, she wouldn't leave, and then escalated from there. That's pretty much what I'm getting from both of their statements. And he's even claimed that she's like beating on him and hit him and all that stuff, but he's not pressing charges. He just wanted her out of the house. So there seems to be a lot going on. I'm not sitting here claiming that I know both sides, because obviously I don't, or I'm taking one side of over the other, because I'm not. But it does seem to happen. This seems to happen a lot, that something will get out and we'll run with it as though it's the complete truth. And the fact of the matter is, there's more than one side to what is going on. Now, unfairly, I think that he did the right thing, but he did what he had to do to protect himself. Because if this had come out the opposite way, that she gets on and says, he kicked me out and he just put me out with his baby, like whatever narrative is first put out is what seems to be run with. I don't agree with putting your business out on social media or going live or any of that. That's not what I do. But in his situation, with his level of fame, with his level of notoriety, I can definitely see why he would do it. Because if he's live, there's zero room for someone to say, oh, well, this is edited, or this was put out after the fact, or something was done to the footage, or this ain't the whole story. If you go live and it's right then and there, there is no disputing what the facts are, what was said, what's going on. So I definitely understand the motive behind the move. And it's sad that you have to do that to protect yourself. That if the narrative got out the opposite way, then it could be shifted a whole different way. It could be the baby did this or the baby did that. And something I don't like that I saw that she did, you could hear in the last clip where she was like, he put me and the baby out, me and his new baby out. She is weaponizing the kid. She is weaponizing the newborn baby to try to get sympathy. And that's a button for me. I do not like when people use children as pawns. You use children to get what you want. You use children to get your way or to drive your point home. When you're going back and forth and you're losing, the first thing that comes out of your mouth is, well, the baby's this or the kid's that. No. The kids are fine. I'm pretty sure that baby could have stayed with I'm not sure if it's a boy or a girl, but I think it's a girl. Could have stayed with her father and everything would have been fine, but you're not going to leave him. You're not going to leave her with her father, because that's taking away a weapon that you can use. Because now it looks like he put you and the baby out, when that's 9 times out of 10 not the scenario. I know, you know, for a fact that kids get used as weapons, kids get used as ammunition in arguments for people to get their way. So that's a real big issue for me, is when someone tries to do that. It's like a crutch to try to pull that sympathy card. Like, oh, well, you can't leave the kids out in the cold. Well, the kids is fine. You got to go. That's the issue. The kids can stay here. The kids got beds. The kids got food. The kids got clothes. You got to figure out your situation. You got to go. And now you're pulling the kids out and taking them out of the house and taking them out in the middle of the night and doing all kind of craziness when you're trying to get sympathy for yourself. And that's the part that raised my antennas of this whole situation. I didn't like when she said that or did that. But that's the only judgment I'm gonna put on this. I don't know the whole story. I'm sure more will come out, and I'll definitely be following it to see what the results of it are. But let's get back into the reason that we're all here, the reason that you all put up with my brand of entertainment, as I like to call it. Let's get back into this music and back into this countdown. Here is our number 4 song. Here is Kanye West featuring The Weeknd and Lil Baby, Hurricane, here on The Mix at 6, here on The Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip-hop countdown. Yeah.
Number 4.
See this in 3D, all lights out for me, all lights out for me. Lightning strikes the beach, 80 degrees, warm it up for me. Finally free, found a part of me, and I want you to see.
To my stomach hurt this month, I done lost 3 friends. Early morning brainstorming, normally I can't sleep in. Sometimes I just wanna restart it, but it all depends. If I'ma be that same young hunger from West End. But my heart is frozen, and the crazy part ain't have no pen. Made back interior came with sheepskin. Still remember when I just had 3 bands. Now I'm the one everyone call on, cause I got deep pants. Bro told me the way to beat the game is on the defense. And never face my name, so they might call me, but they gon' respect it. And I feel like you better off trying to call, I might not get the message. And she just tried to run off with my heart, but I blocked off the X. Yeah.
Oh.
Everybody's so judgmental. Everybody hurts, but I don't judge rentals. It was all so simple.
I see you in 3D. The dawn is bright for me. No more dark for me. I know you're watching me. 80 degrees, burning up the leaves. Finally, I'm free. Finally.
And you're listening to the Mix at 6 here on the Mix 88.9. That was our number 4 song, Kanye West featuring The Weeknd and Lil Baby, Hurricane. And moving right along into our number 3 song, here is Doja Cat and The Weeknd, You Right.
Give me the hip hop countdown.
Number 3.
To the Mix at 6 here on the Mix 88.9. That was our number 3 song, Doja Cat and The Weeknd, You Right. During those last commercials, I was trying to figure out where my Will book is, because I really want that book. And I went on Amazon and checked with them, and they said now was a delay in the shipping. So they told me it's been shipped and to expect it either today or tomorrow, which means it'll be here tomorrow because I've been through this with them before. So tomorrow, my Will book will be here. So I got to wait another day. To start reading my Will book. So I ain't got nothing to do tonight while I'm sitting out in the parking lot at my daughter's practice. So that's good stuff. Oh! I forgot to tell y'all about what happened with Friday's show. People was asking me what happened with Friday's show. Friday's show was a repeat of Thursday's show, and here's why. I recorded Friday's show. I was good to go. I had everything edited. It was perfect. It was a great show. I was feeling so good about it. And then I go to upload it, and then the file says it's corrupted. Okay, this happened before. All you gotta do is restart everything. So I restart everything. I restart the programs I use. I restart the computer. Start everything over. Go back in. It picks back up where I left off. So I got a little bit of editing to do. So I do a little bit of editing and I get everything together and I resave it and it's good to go again. And I go to upload it and it says this file is corrupted. So I'm going back through trying to figure it out because we're getting close to showtime now. And by close, I mean less than 15 minutes. Like it's less than 15 minutes before I'm going on at 6 o'clock and I still got nothing. I have something, but I can't figure out what's going on. And after you finish, I'm gonna take y'all through the process. Once I record, I edit as I go. As I go through everything, I'm editing as I go as much as I can. But at the end, you go back through to make sure all your levels are right, all your sounds are right. You make sure that, you know, there's no empty spaces, no dead air. This is the whole process I go through. So I'm going through and making sure everything is lined up, everything is aligned, everything is right, everything is good to go. And at the very end, you have to mix and render it. So you mix and render your files so that everything sounds the way you're hearing it now. It doesn't sound like that if it's not mixed and rendered together. It sounds completely different. Everything sounds off. So while I'm editing, everything sounds crazy, but that's neither here nor there. So I am at the end, I'm going through and everything is mixing. It takes to mix and render, it takes normally, depending on the time, between five and 10 minutes for it to render and mix. And then once it's rendered and mixed, I gotta convert it to an MP3 file to upload to the station's database so that you hear it at 6. And so, like with 15 minutes left, that's cutting it close, because to convert it to MP3 takes about 3 to 5. And then I have to upload it to the database online, that doesn't take long at all. That's about 15, 20 seconds for it to upload onto there. But if you're keeping up with the timetables, it's about 15 minutes before everything is done. Like, worst case scenario, it's going to take 15 minutes to get everything done. And at that time, the show is starting. So I didn't have time to go back through, find out what the problem is, mix, render, convert, and then upload everything to the site. So I just had to pull it, and I had to rerun the show from Thursday. And what I did was I took the show from Friday, I labeled it the lost episode, and it's up on my YouTube page. So if you want to hear Friday's show, go over to the Fortress of Awesomitude and search Vibe Club for the playlist, and then the lost episode is up. I put it up later that night. I figured out what happened probably about 10 o'clock that night. So I got it uploaded and everything once I got everything figured out. So that's what happened with Friday's episode. And that's where you can listen to Friday's episode if you want. It was a good one. I liked Friday's episode. I was excited for y'all to hear that one. And so I was a little deflated when it didn't work out the way I wanted it to work out. But that's what happens when you're dealing with technology. We're at its mercy. But I love the process. I love the process of editing and getting something, the whole process of creating, I love it. I love having an idea in my head and then translating that idea out in front of me where I can see it and put it out. So if I have an idea of what I want to happen, even as far as the show goes, to piece that all together and then to listen to it at 6 o'clock, it's the best feeling in the world. It's like an adrenaline rush, like getting like, oh, like that's exactly how I wanted it to be. That's exactly what I wanted it to sound like, look like, everything. And for people to dig it, it's the best feeling in the world. So I appreciate y'all going on this journey with me as I live my dream. I'm telling y'all, when I tell y'all I'm living my dream. This is what I wanted to do. I'm having so much fun doing this show, so much fun being here with y'all, so much fun creating content and putting content out and being able to be creative. And this is, when I tell y'all this is my therapy, I mean it. Like, this is where I get all my stuff. I get to just talk and just holding stuff in, and I don't have to hold nothing in. I can talk and say what I want, and well, I don't curse or nothing like that, but I get it out for the most part. And I tell y'all, I'm living my dream is what I'm doing. I am so, so incredibly happy to have this opportunity and this slot. And it is the best feeling in the world. And I don't have anybody to thank but Jack Woodson. So, Jack, I appreciate you, brother. I love you. And thank you for the opportunity. Thank you for giving me this shot. You're the one to put me on. And I'll never forget that. I'll never forget what you gave me and the opportunity you gave me. And because you didn't have to. You know so many other people that have been more qualified for this slot than me. and you took a shot on me, and I'm just hoping I'm not letting you down. I'm having the time of my life, and I hope that I can continue on and just build from here. So I have to say, Jack Woodson, thank you very much. I love you, brother. But back to the reason why I'm here. Back into the music, back into this countdown. Let's get into our number two song. Here is Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More, here on The Mix at 6 on The Mix 88.9.
Give me the hip-hop countdown.
Number two.
Listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number two song, Doja Cat featuring SZA, Kiss Me More. Now, before I get into that number one song, let me take a second to thank some of our sponsors.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
So, who's trying to spend 12 hours in a salon? Not me, and not you either. Nobody wants to spend their whole day like that. Yeah. Pull up and get slayed by the V. I'm trying to put you on. Vanquish Beauty Studio is the move. 2130 Wards Road in Lynchburg. They provide confidence and sass, so it accommodates the swag you already have. Their talented artists specialize in color, cut, healthy, and diverse textures of hair. They're a three-time award-winning salon right in Lynchburg. Vanquish Beauty Studio. They'll turn your hair ideas into a reality without spending the whole day in the salon. So book your appointment now. Go online to VanquishBeautyStudio.com or call 434-239-HAIR. That's 434-239-4247. Experience a professional salon, impeccable style, ambiance, and sophistication all in one place. Vanquish Beauty Studio. Pull up and get slayed by the V.
How do you make financial decisions? Are you retiring soon or wondering how much life insurance is enough? Your family and financial future is the most important thing, and having answers to these questions are mandatory. Bold Financial Strategies is a successful financial team that can help you answer these questions while achieving your goals. Bold Financial Strategies offers a suite of services that range from retirement plans and college savings to homeowners insurance policies, as well as estate planning and life insurance protection. We pride ourselves on making the process simple and understandable for all of our clients. Take control of your financial future and visit our website at boldfinancialstrategies.com or give us a call at 434-215-0695. The team of advisors includes owner Damon Bolden, Garnett Spanky McDaniel, Randy Calloway, and Devin Bowling. We are located at 3712 Old Forest Road, Suite 400, Lynchburg, Virginia. Oh, and we also make ourselves available for online and virtual appointments. Bold Financial Strategies. We help all of our clients plan and make smarter financial decisions, and we would love to start with yours.
The Mix 88.9 presents December to Remember, a Candy Cane Cabaret, Saturday, December 18th at Boonesboro Ruitton Club, 1499 Coffee Road in Lynchburg.
It's that time of year again.
Christmas.
Come party with us holiday style.
Let's go.
Music provided by the Mix 88.9's own DJs, Chaos the Connoisseur, DJ Cool V, and DJ Kid New, the talk of New York.
Oh!
Get your advance tickets at themixradio.online by phone 434-300-8940. Where part of the proceeds will go to support Virginia Prep Sports Academy. December to Remember, a Candy Cane Cabaret. Saturday, December 18th at Boonesboro Ruitton Club in Lynchburg. Doors open at 9. This cabaret is BYOB. Brought to you by The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's number one station for hip-hop and R&B, soul and reggae.
It's time for The Mix at 6. Counting down the top hip-hop and R&B songs in the country. On The Mix 88.9. Lynchburg's number one station for hip-hop and R&B. Soul and reggae.
Give me the hip-hop countdown.
Yeah. This is the number one song.
Number one.
Yeah.
DJ gon' play it.
For this sir, too sexy for your girl, too sexy for this world, too sexy for this ice, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain, too sexy for your game, too sexy for this fame, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap, too sexy for that cap, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah.
Okay, alright, that's fine, okay,
okay.
Feeling too sexy to accept requests.
Way too sexy.
And I'm way too sexy to go unprotected.
Way too sexy.
And she popped a Tesla, now she gonna let you.
Choo-choo.
Okay, alright, that's fine. Okay, think we got too sexy for that metro housing.
Way too sexy.
Diamond popped out, almost swallowed 60,000.
60 pieces.
Section need more things in here, I like it crowded.
Hey. Whoa, whoa.
Yeah, I like it crowded. Oh, you like the boy, well tell me what you like about him. You a turnt, a little thotty, ain't no wife about it. I'ma f*** friends and send her back to metro housing.
Yeah, whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm too sexy for this sir, too sexy for your girl, too sexy for this world, too sexy for this ice, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain, too sexy for your game, too sexy for this fame, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap, too sexy for that cap, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah. Yeah. I pop out, get ghosts on the bitch, you don't know where I went. Pray for all my dogs, all my behind the fence. Dripping in and out, spilling in a new designer gear by a coaster. Pay attention to the detail, going two-tone on choker. Young always ready to murk, some call them some smokers. Young but motion, you don't make sure the car get did a 360 windmill when I left the scene. That's that action, her best work on her knees. Too sexy for this cash, too sexy for this surf, too sexy for these pills, I'm too sexy for this. I get cash wherever I fly, got on me. Money cars and all the jewelry make a sexy. I get cash wherever I fly, got on me. Yeah, whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm too sexy for this sir, too sexy for your girl, too sexy for this world, too sexy for this ice, too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain, too sexy for your game, too sexy for this fame. Yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap, too sexy for that cap, too sexy for that jack. Yeah, yeah.
Too sexy to count 50, my neck, Bugatti, red diamond, spaghetti. This paper, I shred it, I swindle, no sweating. I saw you begging, goddamn you petty. I ain't done spinning, no pin pinch, I spin it. Bags in and out, my man ain't gon' steal it. 100 bags for maybe young, wish they was rich. A Green Gators, they look like a switch. Giorgio, I spent 26 licks. Too sexy, my neck, Bugatti. Caress me, I'll let you today ski. I've been kicking, might need a prosthetic. I pray to the chopper on my pillow, to fairy.
And you're listening to The Mix at 6 here on The Mix 88.9. That was our number one song, Drake featuring Future and Young Thug, Way Too Sexy. Now comes a time of the show that is dedicated to you, the fans, the faithful listeners, the people who keep coming back. And for you all, I say thank you. I say thank you because there is no me without you. If you're not here to support me, there is no purpose in me being here. So I have no choice but to thank you and let you know that I am forever humbled and I am forever grateful that you all enjoy me enough to keep coming back. If you're new here and you enjoyed everything, please come back tomorrow. I am here Monday through Friday, 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern. And if you could do me just one little favor, let someone else know. Spread the word. Let them know that all they have to do is download the app. Go to the Google Play Store or Apple App Store. Search The Mix 88.9. Download that app and they can be here with me Monday through Friday, just as I hope you will come back as well. If you didn't like the show, if you hated the show and you ain't never coming back again, do me a favor. Tell an enemy, tell someone you hate to listen to the show. There is no bigger revenge than getting someone to listen to something that you hated. So if you hate it, let an enemy know. If you love it, tell a friend. If you hate it, tell an enemy. That's all I ask. But anyway, you can also follow us on social media. Facebook and Instagram, The Mix 88.9, and on Twitter, The Mix 8991. You can listen to us online stream on your computer. Go to The Mix Radio, all one word, .online, and we're streaming there. We're here on the app and there on the stream. I say here and there like I'm not in both places right now, but we're on both platforms 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We got old school, new school, reggae, inspirational, anything you need, we got you covered. Just come back and hang out with us. That's all you gotta do is click the button, just hang out. If you've liked me personally, if you want to follow me personally, easy peasy, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Twitch, Discord, everything that you can think of, I am on it. Kalel Creed DB. That's KalelCreedDB. And you can click follow, you can click share, you can click all the buttons to let everybody know that you are following me, and I am forever appreciative. If you've missed any part of this show and you want to catch up on this show and past episodes, as I mentioned earlier, go over to my YouTube page, The Fortress of Awesometude. That's AwesomeTude. Search the Vibe Club playlist, and there it is, every episode that I've ever done. But that's going to do it for me today. Stay where you're at, because following me is DJ Kid New in the recovery room. But this Monday is done for me. You all have a great evening. Take care of yourself, and I will see you here tomorrow.